a man not to. He had a choice. God the Father gave him a choice. He said, Lord, if it's your will, let this cup pass. Amen. And praise service. At this time, we're going to move on in our Easter program, our day of Easter. Amen. We want you to go and enjoy your families. Amen. After we leave. Amen. We are here on this Easter Sunday to commemorate the life and death, burial, the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the Anointed One and His Anointed. Thank you, sir. Amen. We would like to pray, amen, for your well-being this morning. We would like to pray that God, amen, blesses you, like you said, with His favor. We would like to pray that God would give us the understanding, amen, of the reason that He rose again. It wasn't for Him. He was obeying the Father, but it was for us. And as we pray, let us, amen, remember others. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Father, bow your head with me, please. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you that we have, Lord God, Jesus, the privilege of being in this place at this time, in the land of the living, Lord Jesus, where we can, Lord God, Jesus, have a chance to worship and praise you once again. We thank you for allowing us to see another Easter Sunday. We thank you, Lord God, Jesus, for this commemoration service of how you died, how you was buried, how you rose again. And you didn't stop there, but you took the blood all the way back to the mercy seat. And you come all the way back down here again to show yourself and to prove, Lord God, to those men and women, Thomas and Mary, amen, and the other apostles, that you were alive forevermore. We thank you, Lord God, that you're still alive. You're living in our hearts and in our minds right now. We thank you, Lord God Jesus, that you are the risen Savior in the world today. We thank you, Lord God Jesus, for the promise that you kept. For you said, I go away to prepare a place for you. And when I come again, I'll receive you to myself. You said that you would send the Comforter. And you did. And it is your Holy Spirit dwelling in us. Thank you again for, Lord God, keeping your promise. And help us, Lord God, to keep ours. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
We see that in John chapter 3, verse 16, the King James Version said, For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Amen. In our scripture text that we will be looking at, we will be in Romans, the 6th chapter, 1 through the 4th verse. Romans, the 6th chapter, 1 through the 4th verse. If you have that, say amen.
Amen.
I'm going to wait for everybody. Romans, the 6th chapter, 1 through the 4th verse.
Amen.
Amen. Here are a few more pages. And it reads, What shall we say then? Shall we continue in sin that grace may abound? Verse 2 says, God forbid. How shall we that are dead to sin live any longer therein? Know ye not that so many of us as were baptized into Christ, into Jesus Christ, were baptized into his death. Therefore we are buried with him by baptism into death, that life as Christ was raised up from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so, we also should walk in newness of life. We see that in this particular text, I believe, written by Paul. Amen. He is giving us divine revelation into, amen, something that has never happened before. Amen. He's talking about, amen, being risen with God, baptized, amen, in the water, amen, which is a symbolization of being buried with him into his death. And if we are buried with him in the symbolization into water, which characterizes, amen, the attitude of dying, we shall also be raised, amen, with him. This can only, amen, be done by faith. Look at your neighbor and say, it can only
be done by faith.
It's dying to sin. That's what he is talking about, dying to sin. Dying to a sinful nature, a sinful mindset. Dying out to old sinful things, things that cause us to be bound, amen, to be, amen, enslaved. It's by faith, because the only way that we can, amen, rise in newness of life is to be buried with him in baptism in water, amen, and spirit.
Amen.
The Bible says that we are buried with him for the remission of our sins. But he removes our sins not by the water in which we are buried, but his blood was shed to take away our sins.
Amen.
For without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. But when we go down in the water, amen, we are buried in his likeness. We are buried like him. So when we are buried in the water in his likeness, when we come up out of the water, the mindset should be that the old man, the old woman, that old nature, amen, remains buried, hallelujah.
Amen.
And when I rise up with a new nature, a new character, a new mindset, if you would. Amen. All things are passed away, the Bible declares. And behold, look, all things are become new. God is saying, look, observe. You got to observe, look at it, amen. You have a new life, a new mindset, a new character, a new attitude. The way you act should be, amen, different from what you used to act after you come up out of, amen, the water. We are buried with him in baptism, amen, in likeness, amen, in symbolization to his death. And we are also buried in the spirit. We are baptized into his spirit. His spirit comes upon us, amen. Dwells in us. Hallelujah. Being baptized in the water and being baptized, I believe, in the fire is what God told John the Baptist that would happen. It would come. Amen. It has come. And it is here. But for some reason, as I see Paul, amen, in the Word, he had to go back, amen, and talk to the Romans because, amen, after you have been buried with him in the likeness of his death, that old nature, amen, does not just leave and go away.
Amen.
Some reason it hangs around.
Yes.
Hangs around, amen, to the point of where, amen, you have to prove something now.
Yes.
Because Paul goes on over in the, amen, chapter 12 and says, you got to prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Because he literally will baptize, amen, in symbolization in the likeness of his death. You rose with the newness of life. You still, amen, live in that same old, amen, atmosphere called the world.
Yes.
To be in the world, but not of the world.
Yes.
With your new mind, you have to walk, amen, through sinful places.
Amen.
With a new mindset, a new character, amen, you have to, amen, deal with sinful atmosphere.
Yeah,
yeah. The Bible says that the devil is the prince of the air. Amen. You breathe this air. You walk in this air. Why? Because you, this body needs air to live.
Yeah.
You need life in this body to live.
Yeah.
As long as you're in this body, the Bible says there's no good thing in this old flesh. Nothing good in it. Amen. Yeah. As long as you live in the flesh, you shall suffer persecution.
Yeah.
Amen. Don't think you're going to, amen, walk in the newness of life and not suffer anything. Hallelujah. Jesus, amen, got the command from his Father to go down into the earth, step out of eternity into time, go down into earth, and I want you to die. Some of it died for those people so that they can have a right to, amen, everlasting life. Did Jesus have to suffer?
Yes.
I guess we're going to have to suffer too. Hallelujah. Did Jesus have to obey the Father?
Yes.
I guess we're going to have to obey the Word of God too.
Yes.
Did Jesus, amen, man need the Spirit of the living Father on the inside of him?
Yes.
Yes, he is. But we want to have the Spirit too. Oh, I think that I'm talking to somebody to see this. Hallelujah. Did they call it all kind of names? They all call you some names too. When he come up out of the water, amen, it said a dove ascended on him, amen, the Spirit ascended on him in the form of a dove. A voice come out of heaven and said, this is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. So if God said that about Jesus, guess what? He gonna say that about Jesus. Can we talk about new?
Yes.
Amen. New word. Newest is an adjective of new. Having been made or come to being, amen, only a short time ago.
Yes.
Happened only a short time ago, amen. Something new, amen. You don't get new things very often.
That's right.
Don't get new. I remember when me and co-pastor, we got a car. Amen. It was a new car. It was about a new car. It was brand new. You know what she said? She hold my head like she said, I want to, amen, drive something that nobody else has never driven before.
Yes.
I want to drive something and nobody ain't smoked up.
Yes.
I want to drive something and nobody liquored up. Amen.
Yes. Yes.
Do all kind of stuff in. Hallelujah. I want to drive something new, and we went, and God blessed us to get a new car. The Bible said, God will give you the desire of your heart.
Amen.
Amen. Something, amen, that you recently got. Something that you get, amen, that has not been acquired by anybody else before. Amen. Something new. It's nice to get new clothes every now and then. I know you ladies like to go shopping and get a new pair of shoes. Amen. Every now and then.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. I don't know about you, but amen. Every now and then I like to go to amen and buy a new watch. Amen. I see this white one. Amen. I was looking through the cabinet. I said, that looks nice. I never had one of those before. Amen. It's nice to get something new every now and then. It makes you feel good.
Yeah.
It makes you feel like you have accomplished something.
That's right.
It makes you feel like you're coming out, amen, of old things. Amen. And you're stepping into an area you've never been before.
Amen.
Or you have something that has not been possessed before. Sometimes you take time and look at what you have.
Yes, sir.
That you have new. And you thank God for it.
Yes.
Amen. Because everybody can't get new stuff all the time.
Amen.
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 Some of us, amen, that went to school, amen, and they offered you, amen, something that they did not offer everybody else before you. Amen. Hallelujah. They offered you a scholarship, a new scholarship. You were the recipient of that scholarship. Amen. And when you got that scholarship, amen, you used it for your education. After you graduated, amen, hallelujah, you may have stepped into a business of your own or a business with a partnership. In other words, you stepped into a new venture.
Amen.
Somewhere you have never been before. when you step into new things and places that you have never been before, amen, you need sometimes somebody there to help and to lead and to guide you along the way.
That's right.
I've seen, amen, TV shows where people step into the venture, amen, they had the money, the capital, they stepped into a venture of buying a restaurant, but they did not have, amen, the business knowledge of how to run the restaurant. Just because you have money to buy a restaurant does not mean you know how to run a restaurant. Amen. Just because, amen, God bless you to graduate from college does not mean you know everything just because you have your sheepskin hand on the wall. Amen. So I just come to, amen, let you know that God called us to walk in the newness of life. Now, when you get over to the newness of life, you're also going to be faced with some of those same old things.
Amen.
And when you don't know how to walk in the newness of life, amen, you revert back to some of those same old things.
Amen.
Or the same old ways.
Amen.
Amen. When you don't tell me that people, amen, that have ventured out into, amen, a new business, did not know everything, had money starting out, but 3 years down the road, I believe they said for the first 3 to 5 years, you ain't going to make, amen, no money. You're going to be putting all the money into your business. But some of those folks, I mean, when they run out of money, if they were going to keep the business going, they reverted to some of those same old sneaky ways. Hallelujah. That they got money the first place. Amen. And if we don't be careful as Christians, we're going to revert back to some of those same old things. You don't even have to, amen, worry about, amen, finding them. They will find you. The devil, amen, knows where you are. Hallelujah. And not only do he know where you are, he knows what you like. Knowing that, he comes, amen, to tempt you, to try to cause you to revert back to the same old thing. The reason why I know this is true is because as soon as Jesus was baptized, come up out of the water, the devil called on him. He heard his voice from the Father. Amen. Hallelujah. This is my son in which I am well pleased. Amen. He, amen, disappeared out of their sight into a high mountain. And he fasted for 40 days and 40 nights. The devil was standing off looking at him and watching him. After the 40 day and 40 night fast, the devil presented himself to God. Amen. And he said, if you be the Christ, good God. If I said, you got to know who you are. Oh, I heard in the Sunday school say that many of us don't know who we are. Amen. They don't know. We don't know who called us and the power that we have. We don't understand, amen, walking in this newness of life in its totality. But Jesus knew who he was. Amen. Even in his weakest point, one of his most weakest points, amen, the devil tried and tempted him. He said, if you be the Son of God, command this stone to be made bread. Jesus said that man should not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. When you walk in the newness of life, amen, you can't do it on your own power like you used to.
Yeah.
we get you to thank.
That's
what we want you to thank.
Yes.
Glory, glory.
The thing about it is, he didn't leave then. Mm-hmm. See, if you be the Son of God, you see all of these lands and all of these cities, he said, I'll give it all to you. Hallelujah. If you only would bow down and worship me.
Mm-hmm.
That's all I wanted in this. Just bow
down.
Hallelujah. It's something. Amen. We bow down a lot of stuff.
Amen.
Come on, get close, get all the way down. Amen. You remember, God said, I'm better than this. In his head. I suppose, amen, the Bible says, Spirit bring all things to your remembrance.
Yes,
the Word of God said, the earth is the Lord.
Yes,
and the fullness
there.
So how in the world the devil standing in front of Jesus say, I'm going to give you all this if you only bow down and everything belongs to him anyway.
Yeah.
So that was a tricky thought. Amen. He's trying to get you to bow down to him. Amen. And he says he's going to give you something that you already have.
Mm-hmm.
The devil is a lie.
Yes, he is.
The father of a lie.
Yes, he
is. Amen. That's all we know how to do is lie.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes,
but when Jesus, amen, realized everything that the devil tried to do, he passed every test one after the other. Were they easy? No. Were they confusing? Yes. Amen. That's why you have to read what the Word of God is.
Mm-hmm.
Yes,
the Word of God is the will of God.
Yes, sir.
Do you know what the will of God is for your life?
Yes,
do you know what God wants you to be and to become? Do you know what God wants you to do? It's right in here. This is the will of God.
Amen.
The will and testament of God. Old and New Testament, amen, canonized into books, amen, put together, canonized, bound together, is the will of God.
Yes.
What is it talking about? It's talking about the will, last will and testament of God for you.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. He died so that we may have life. Yes. Do you want life? Read how to get life.
Yes.
It's just like going into the lawyer's office. When your father had left you the last will and testament of everything that he owned, he gave it all to you. And you have three or four sisters and brothers, or three or four siblings, you ain't getting all of it, they getting some too. But you have to come in and sit down in the lawyer's office to find out what daddy left you. Amen. Because when you left your sisters and brothers, amen, ain't got nothing to do with it.
You that's right.
And I'm struggling right now in some areas. My mama is still, amen, living at the home place. She owns the property. She has everything. But she done wheeled everything out. Most of it's still in her name, but she done wheeled it out. Do you understand what I'm saying? She's still alive. She done wheeled it all out. The problem that I'm having with is the home itself. Amen. She don't have a job. She is on benefits, Social Security. So whenever something breaks, it goes down on the house, amen, she didn't leave me the house. She left it to my baby sister. And her husband would get all of the house and all the property. But when something breaks down, baby sister and hubby ain't coming to fix nothing. They're not putting no money in there. They have an investment that they're going to put money in. Oh, they have an inheritance that they're going to get that they won't put money in to make sure to keep it up for them when they get it. All they got to do is put a little bit of money. $1,000 a year ain't much. You keep the house going and fixed up. But when mama passes, they get everything. That's over $100,000 worth of house sitting there in front. Now, is it an investment for me to put $1,000 a year into an investment of $100,000 that I am going to get after my mom passed? Is that an investment?
Yeah.
And you're not willing to invest it.
Mm-hmm.
you're not willing to. My problem is, amen, because she's my mama. Oh, stop. My mama stays care of. When something break down, amen, amen, God may go past me to be the Abraham and Sarah of our family. Hallelujah. Oh yeah, he may also be the Abraham and Sarah of our family. Hallelujah. And every now and then I think, my God, I got to pay, amen, to keep property up, this, that, and the other, and my sister don't get everything, and her husband. Amen. Hallelujah. But I'm giving my money. God lets me know I blessed you in the earth. I call you to do this. I call you. You don't give up. Right now, you know what I call you to do. I'm so glad Jesus. Amen. You can show. Amen. You was going to be the one that got it. You was the one that got hallelujah. We got to change our mindset to think like Jesus thought. Amen. And he blessed me. He blessed me. How did he bless you, Pastor? Because when my mama gave me my part of my inheritance, I'm the only one right now who's got an inheritance in my name. Oh, Pastor, now I got the inheritance in our name. Hallelujah. You y'all understand what I'm talking about? Because if mama go to the nursing home will put a stop on all of the problems.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And they'll get every last dime.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. Yes, they will.
Not only that, but they can, amen, if mama put give me everything and I have it in my name and it's 5 years hadn't gone by yet, they can still come and get
me. Yes, sir. Amen.
God blesses us.
Amen.
Amen. Put us in position.
There
can't nobody take nothing from us. Jesus put us in a position that the devil can't take nothing from us.
Yeah.
I said the devil cannot take one thing from you. He died, amen, and gave us an inheritance of sonship. Say it with me. Sonship.
Sonship.
Daughtership.
Daughtership.
Justification.
Justification.
Righteousness.
Righteousness.
Propitiation.
Propitiation.
I know you can't say it. Propitiation.
Propitiation.
Mercy.
Mercy.
Grace.
Grace.
God give us all of this.
Yes, sir.
He gave us an inheritance. He gave us all of this.
That's right.
And some of us are letting the devil take it from us. That's the problem. Some of us are letting the devil take it right from us.
Man.
Amen. So I come to you, amen. Stir up your pure mind today. When Jesus rose up again, he rose up with all power in his hand. He gave us something new. And it's in our mindset. You have to change your mindset. You have to, amen, shift your mind. Amen. Because when he gave it to us, he gave us some things, amen, that the devil can't take. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away, and behold, all things are become new. Somebody say all things.
All
say
things.
It again, all things.
All
say
things.
It again, all things.
All things.
Everything is brand new. Amen. Hallelujah. If we be in him, we are new creatures.
Yeah.
Amen. Not previously experienced. Amen. Or encountered. God will give you an experience and an encounter you never had before.
Amen.
Brand new. Hallelujah.
Mm-hmm.
But God, amen, give us new things if we be in him. We are new creatures. Hallelujah. Recently obtained or acquired. He will give you something you ain't never had before.
Amen.
He'll give you additional stuff. Amen.
Amen.
He blesses you not only just because, amen, your sonship, but he gives you favor. He gives you other stuff.
Amen.
Amen. He covers you. He keeps you.
Yes.
Amen. He blesses
yes.
you.
Yes.
Amen. He puts you in a position that when the devil come looking for you, he can't find you. The reason why some of y'all still got your mind is because the devil couldn't find you. Oh, he's coming trying to take stuff from you. The reason why you're still living is because the devil couldn't find you. The Bible says if you walk up and down through the stone of the earth, seeking who he made you by, he will come in your way. For God is a woman snatched you. See, God's coming and telling you right here.
Amen.
I said God's coming and telling you right now. Why? Because he loves
you.
God so loved the world, us, that he gave his only begotten Son. Whosoever believeth in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. You are an investment to God the Father. And anytime you invest in something, amen, just because it's not doing good right now, because it's not making gains right now. Companies on the stock market, but the stocks in the company is not going up, they're going down. Do you just chunk everything in and give up the company?
No,
you keep going at it.
Yeah.
Because I know next year is coming.
Yes.
Let's make it through this year.
Yes.
Some of you are going through a season right now.
Amen.
You're not going up, you're going down. But if you can just hold on to the season, is over. God said a new season. I've been and some of the things I've done.
Amen.
You wouldn't let me come up here and preach. But I'm so glad God covered me.
Yes.
Right.
And he helped me get myself together.
Yes.
Listen to neighbor, say
neighbor.
It ain't over. Till God says it's over. Tell somebody that said it ain't over. Till God says it's over. I may not be what I want to be, but I thank God that I'm where I used to be. Experience before.
Right.
New things. Amen. Places you haven't been. You ain't going to understand everything. You ain't going to see everything.
Thank you, Lord.
But God's got you covered.
Thank you, Lord.
Jesus said on the night when he was to be taken, amen, to be crucified or be taken to be judged. He called the men that were with him together to prepare supper. He told them to go in the city, which is over beside you. You see, if you shall see a man carrying some water, when you go in the house, follow him and tell him, amen, that we need a place, hallelujah, so that we may dine and to prepare, amen, a place for supper. They did, and they prepared supper for Jesus. The disciples were there, all just the disciples, amen, all 12 of them. And we see that there was a man in the midst by the name of Judas who betrayed Jesus. And as they were in the room, Jesus began to talk to them, and he began to show them how they are to become servants one to another. The old mindset had to be passed away. The mindset of James and John. Lord God, when you come into your kingdom, amen, can I sit on one side and my brother sit on the other side? Amen. Jesus is, amen, mindset was we have to become servants one to another.
Mm-hmm.
So he wrapped the towel around him. And he poured water and he humbled himself. And he began to wash their feet. One man in the group said, "You won't wash my feet." Jesus said, "If I don't wash your feet, you won't have part in the lot with me." His name was Peter. And Peter, understanding that, said, I believe he said, "Lord, don't just wash my feet. Wash my hands and my head also." Amen.
Yeah. Yeah.
We see, amen, that there were different attitudes in that room that night. Amen. And those attitudes had to be changed. Because Jesus was leaving and he was going away. Amen. And he picked up the bread. Wasn't a loaf of bread. It was a big round piece of bread that the Jewish people have. I forgot what it's called, but he blessed it and he broke the bread. Not only did he wash the feet, he blessed and broke the bread, but he also, amen, said, "My blood, drink of it, the wine of the vine, fruit of the vine, represents my blood. The bread represents my body, which is broken. The wine represents my body, represents my blood, which will be spilled, which will be shed." Glory, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And when you eat as oft as you do it, do this in remembrance of me. You break my body and you drink, amen, of the fruit of the vine, which represents my blood that was shed for you. Amen. As often as you do this, do it in remembrance of what I did for you. This morning, amen, we would like to, amen, participate in communion. Amen. Now, communion service, the Bible lets us know that this is not to be taken lightly. Amen. Communion is not to be taken lightly. Amen. When we partake of communion, amen, we find ourselves, amen, partaking of the body of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
And of his blood.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God.
As I was reading in the Word of God, the will of God, it's so important that he wrote about it. 1 Corinthians, the 11th chapter, starting at the 23rd verse. Listen, please. Please listen closely. "For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, 'Take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me.' After the same manner also he took the cup when he had supped, saying, 'This cup is the New Testament of my blood. This do ye as oft as ye drink it in remembrance of me.' For as often as ye eat this bread and drink this cup, ye do show the Lord's death till he come. Wherefore, whosoever shall eat this bread," listen, "and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily, shall be guilty of the body and blood of the Lord. But let a man examine himself, let a woman examine herself, and so let him or her eat of that bread and drink of that cup." I want to read on about four more verses. "For he that eateth and drinketh unworthily, eateth and drinketh damnation to himself or herself, not discerning the Lord's body. For this cause many are weak and sickly among you, and many," the Bible says in the King James Version, "sleep, or many die, because they drunk or they took, amen, of the elements of the Lord's body unworthily."
Jesus.
For if ye would judge yourselves, examine your own self. Pastor is not the one to examine you. You examine your own self. You know whether you're worthy or whether you're not unworthy. Amen. You know whether you, amen, can partake or can't partake. If you're living a life, the partaking of the elements of Christ's body is for saved folks only. Amen. And if you're claiming to be a Christian and you're not living the lifestyle of God's word, don't partake of the Lord's body. You're not at the place. You judge yourself. Amen. I'm giving you, amen, the understanding and the statements out of God's word. Because there are many that have, amen, partook and they have become sick.